public offering to the people of San Francisco. A gentrification that is fueled by real estate speculation. We have evicted, displaced, gentrified indigenous communities of color and working people of San Francisco. We ask Twitter, where is our IPO? Is it an invisible public offering? Where is your public offering from your tax-free perch here on Market Street? The following names are the names of elders and families evicted by tech company fueled gentrification here in San Francisco. So, Mark, please read the names, sir.
Jeremy Michael. Kathy Delvin. The Lee family. Peter Green. Mary Phillips. Renee and Ace. The Mama's of Mama House. Ethel Silverstein. Kay Cabral. Joyce Dawson. Nessa Smith. Vivian Hayes. Ty Leon Yu. Ruben Yarnil. Steve Allen. The Capriva family. Aaron Shen. Anthony Pan. Pancho Sandoval.
Death by displacement. Death by displacement.
Gentrification is death. Gentrification is death.
Twitter fuels gentrification. Twitter fuels gentrification. Tech fuels gentrification.
Tech billionaires don't care about evicted elders.
$56 million in tax rate. Twitter. Tax-free perch. Tax-free perch. Sits on their tax-free perch.
Thank you for being here, guys. And trust me, the world is the one that's watching. Americans might want to keep it quiet and lead lives as they usually do, which is quite oblivious.
IPO, invisible public offering. IPO, invisible public offering. IPO, invisible public offering. IPO, invisible public offering.
We say to Twitter, what's your offering to the public? As we, the public, the evicted, the displaced, the gentrified, are taken out of our community, so we can't even live here anymore.
Twitter tax break. Full switch. Full switch. Full switch.
They're speaking for more multi-million dollar condos. We need housing for workers. COVID. There's an epidemic of eviction all over San Francisco. And so we want to ask you, Twitter, what is your public offering? There have been countless of families, seniors, adults with disabilities that are in need of affordable housing. And we have seen the rise of rent within the year. What have you contributed to the community?
Nosotros tenemos derecho a vivir tranquilos.
We
have the right to live peacefully and happily.
Yeah.
Yes or no?
Yeah.
Are we willing to fight for this peace?
Yeah. Cuando
tengamos nosotros reuniones en el Civil para defender estos derechos de vivienda, por favor, acompáñenme.
When we have meetings in City Hall to fight for our rights to live in San Francisco, you got to come.
Y esta es una llave bien grande que tenemos que usar.
That's a big key. That's a big strength.
You know, the eviction report that is had that from last year, the highest eviction that is being faced right now is District 6. That is the Soma community. The second is the Hunters Bay Point. And the third is the Mission District. And these are the districts that always being faced with gentrification over and over again. And we are being faced right now. So, actually today I have a client with me who went through looking for housing because they are being asked to move out. And she's going to say in her native tongue, Tagalog, and I'm going to translate it for her.
Before she conception malingit, at kami po ay dati nakatira sa I-5 last trip. Ngayon po ay nakatira nasa bayanihan, SRO Hotel. Noong kami po ay nakatira sa Rush Street, wala po kaming privacy dahil po ang aming kwarto ay napakalihim. Siya po ang pinakamalit sa tatlong kwarto. Pero ngayon nakahanap kami ng decenteng tirahan sa SRO Hotel. Doon lang namin naranasan kung gaano kahirap maghanap ng matitirahan dito sa San Francisco. Lalo na sa aming kalagayan, kami ay nakatanggap lamang galing sa aming pension, sa Social Security. Ito ay hindi sapat sa aming pangangailangan. Ito po ang aming istorya. Maraming salamat po. Thank you.
Are we gonna let our seniors and our community members with disabilities be pushed out under the street? When do we want? Stop the eviction. When do we want it? Now. When do we want? Stop the eviction. When do we want it?
Now.
When do we want?
Stop the eviction.
When do we want it?
Now.
When do we want?
Stop the eviction.
When do we want it?
Now.
We're gonna take to the streets. We're gonna be here today. We're gonna keep on coming back. We're not gonna let Twitter know that they can get away with this. We're not gonna let any of these tech companies get away with this. We need to form a resistance. We need to come out in numbers. Every time that there is an eviction, we need to be outside of that house. We need to go to the landlord's house. We need to make people know who these landlords are, who the CEOs of these companies are, who the speculators are that are evicting our community members. One of the cases we're working on right now is a company called Urban Green. People in Urban Green, you know what? They own 5 buildings in the city, 140 units. They're LSFing all of those units, flipping them, and trying to sell them for high-end luxury condos. Not okay. We're not going to stand for that. No more. We're gonna be outside of the CEO of that company, David Lepofsky, his house. We're gonna go to every single unit that's being evicted and stand there and, in solidarity with those folks being displaced. We cannot let that happen. We cannot let that happen anymore. We are seeing a woman named Mary being evicted on her 98th birthday in April. No. What kind of city evicts a 98-year-old woman from her house? Not this city. No more.
I have been living here in Soma for over 40 years now. And it's the same house for over 30 years. In that house, I have my 3 children, my 8-year-old dad, my 88-year-old mom, and my other siblings, and nieces. Living here for over 40 years, I have never seen a massive displacement of residents until now. I have many friends who have to move out of the community because of gentrification. My own family had experienced discrimination and went through 3 rounds of Ellis Act eviction. We are now going through the process of the 4th round. We are having a hearing this coming December 6th at the rent board. We are victims of the abuse system. to hear this. We are victims because of you, fueled by the incoming tech companies. Thus, you know, the rise of rents and no care whatsoever from companies like you. My mother and father are always good people to tell me to be strong and fight for family and community. Families like me not only fear about having a home to stay in, but also struggle to meet our basic needs, like housing, food, transportation, education. Here in the South of Market, we have Bessie Carmichael Filipino Education Center School, the Galing Bata and other school after-school programs, parks that are either underfunded or on a threat of being cut. Yet Twitter is getting a tax break that could have been going to all these important community needs. I don't understand. With the 8th Washington development, which we won with no one being seen, was supposed to create revenue, but yet we're losing $56 million from the tech company. Tax break? What is this, a cover-up?
More than that.
So we asked Twitter and other tech companies, what is your public offering to the people of San Francisco? You come barging into our city and nonchalantly step all over us as if you own this city and as if there are no people living here. You either not care, or just plainly are blinded by money, or just plainly disrespectful.
Read it. Take it all away.
We demand that they hire local residents. We demand that you get back to our schools, our nonprofit organizations, our communities. We want the city to help stop the Ellis Act eviction. I'm calling on you, Mayor Ed Lee, and your administration. We are not leaving our home. This is our home, San Francisco. We want the chair of the Community Advisory Committee to be part of the negotiation of the Community Benefit Agreement from the beginning. Last Tuesday's voting depict a clear picture that San Franciscans are fed up. I'm standing here in front of you right now because I decided to make a stand along with every one of you and make it clear to the city's administration that San Francisco will not back out.
Okay, no.
We will continue to fight until our demands are met.
Okay.
The people are united and will never be defeated. The people united 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 will never be defeated.
Right? How many people here have seen their neighborhood change? They can no longer afford to be there. We're in a crisis. We're in a crisis. And I'm here from Power. We organize in low-income female and African-American community members, and we're part of San Francisco Rising, which is an alliance of 9 organizations from around the city that's fighting displacement in all of our communities. And we're here today to fight Twitter and the displacement that's happening here in the South of Market. I just want to say something really briefly about the gentrification of transit that is also happening. So Angelica mentioned that Twitter, when they opened here, was given a free muni bus line straight from where we are right now. to Caltrain. And when they went to the city to get this bus line, the city said it wasn't going to cost them anything. They said it was cost neutral.
Oh!
So these are the kind of lies that we get from the Mayor Lee administration. Because when we fight for transit in our neighborhood, for bus lines to the Bayview, for bus lines to Visitation Valley, they tell us they can't afford it, right? And when we build City Hall for months, and actually for years, fighting for free bus passes for youth, so they could just get to school, they told us they couldn't afford it. But we won that campaign, and we now have a great program for the free bus passes for youth that only costs about $3 to $5 million a year, and it could easily be paid for, right, by the Twitter tax break, along with all the other programs that we so desperately need in our community. So this is what we're getting with the Mayor Lee administration, backed by Ron Conway and Silicon Valley. They're giving a pass to the technology companies that are not supporting our community, that we've had enough. We're going to fight back. We're going to push back. I don't know how many people here know about Proposition B and C, but the city is saying no to developers, no to gentrification. And Mayor Lee's going to wake up and support what we need. Thank you.
Yeah. I'm here just like you, showing what democracy is all about. This is how we win. When we come together like this, and we fight, and we show corporations of America, not just Twitter, but corporations of America that are getting these breaks, that we don't even give our city finance, the police, the kind of break that they're getting.
Okay.
Now, we got to look at the reality of it. The only way we're going to win is to stick together and do what we're doing right now.
No!
Do what we're doing right now. It's protest. Stand up, be seen, be heard. Step out. You've heard a whole lot of people talk about right here, we do have to go to their homes. We do have to go in front of their corporations. If you want to win, we have to do the things that you think they think in the box. We have to think out the box. These are the moves that we have to make. You've seen a real positive thing happen here the other day in the elections. Did Prop C and Prop B win?
Yeah.
You know why they didn't win? Because the people voted. What is the power of the people? The vote. That is the power. We can protest, we can holler and scream, but to get the politicians that back these people out of those seats and make them quiver and worry about what we will do is the vote power. We have to keep this vote power up here in our city. And if we can, make it nationally, get it going even more.
Some recent newspaper articles use Twitter as a poster boy for big business over people, worshiping Twitter stock options and dissing the people of my hood. Twitter and like companies are seen as white knights galloping in to save capitalism. But as the current trend continues, San Francisco is becoming one giant neighborhood of wealthy and mostly white people from the Mission to the Sunset.
Right.
In my personal opinion, City Hall was shocked when residents of my building at 1049 Market Street marched down there for a series of meetings, and a number of us are white and or professional. Thousands of people who are employed here in San Francisco are having to move out of this city. The city is losing its people. The city's population looks more like a sports franchise whose players are not even from here.
Right.
And the politicians help to create this problem by offering tax incentives to big business. Excuse me, I expect our politicians to serve the people who put them in office and not to prioritize big business.
Twitter's estimated $26 million tax exemption should go toward a shared investment that builds a dynamic and prosperous community for one and all. For example, an $8 million investment in repairing and replacing outdated elevators in the San Francisco Housing Authority buildings would result in more residents getting out in the community and contributing to the local economy. For working families, it can choose a responsible security contractor that will pay good wages and benefits. Twitter can and should be a leader in setting standards that will benefit the entire community and our economy, not just tech workers and investors and speculators. We all benefit when Twitter takes care of working families in its own backyard. Thank you.
All right.